Hey guys, welcome to another exciting tutorial of creation process, and in this video we'll be preparing a logo in a professional and step-by-step process. So here, to make you understand, I got a design which I saw it and I prepared it in Illustrator, and in here we will understand how this design has been prepared in a professional way. What was the first step and what was the last step while preparing this logo? So we'll discuss about that. So let's study this logo first. So here you can see there is a circle with some thickness, and there is a piece of square or rectangle with the same thickness of the circle. So everything is planned, everything is measured. So you don't do it without measurement, without value. So we have to keep that in mind while preparing this. And you can even notice that this part has been cut from here, which is the center of the circle, and this part has been cut, which is the last edge of the circle. So these are the few things we have to notice. This has to be prepared with some proper way, proper step, proper procedure. This is not made randomly. So let's begin how it has been made. So first we'll see how normally people will try to make this stuff. So we will go to ellipse, and normally people will draw a circle, duplicate this, Control C, Control F, and scale it down, and select both the object and go to Pathfinder and subtract it, and you got the circle which looks like similar to this, but this is totally wrong. Here you can see the thickness is constant. Therefore, the thickness of the, they know the thickness of the circle, that's why they know the thickness of the rectangle or a square. But here, you don't know what is the thickness of the circle, so your value is unmeasurable. You can't measure it. And if you want to measure it, you go to scale, and that's totally a difficult way. So everything goes with the flow. So to do that, we'll delete this first. We'll remove this fill color and give some stroke color, and let's give the stroke with some thickness. So I prefer 60 points to draw this part, and I draw, select the ellipse tool and click on the blank area. You got an ellipse tool, ellipse palette, where you decide what should be the width and what should be the height. Here we need a circle, so their height and width is going to be constant, so it's locked. So let's give some around 200 points and click OK. So you got a circle with the stroke thickness of 60 points, and we know the value. So this is the first step we have done. Now next step we can see is that this piece of square, it has the same thickness as the circles. So we know the circle is of 60 points, so we need the stroke thickness of this square also 60 points. So let's draw a square, but we have to keep in mind that this square has been made in a proper way. It is not that the square is made big and it has been cut out. We have to see that. Now I think this square has been made is the length of the the whole diameter of the circle. So let's draw a square of the same length of the diameter of the circle. And to draw out a square, just click shift and drag out the mouse. So you got a proper circle square here. So you got the square, and next step is we see that it's at the center of the point. So make sure that let's bring this square at the center of the circle, and we will keep that in mind that this point intersects the center of the circle. So we'll just drag this in and bring it here, and you can see the intersection here. So here we go, it's the center of the circle and this has been intersected. So it has been done. So now next step is we need a cut from here and here. So we need to cut here and here. To do that, we'll just select a line and draw a line over it. By clicking shift, you get a straight line, and make sure that the point, this line should be black and of thin maybe 2 points, because it's just we need a line which should cut from here, so it's for separation. I have given black color, so in this way we make a line over here too, but it should be parallel to the edge. So we'll just take the line, go to here, and we see that it's parallel, and just shift and drag out, and you got the line. So after this, what we need is we got all the placements, we got all our stops right, we got all our stops right, and everything is in a proper proportion. So next step is we will delete out all the unnecessary stuff which you don't need. So here the first step, we need only this part, and rest we have to remove it. So we have to cut this part away. To do that, first we will select this both object, go to object path, and go to object and expand it. This will convert that strokes into object, that means it's a fill object. Now we will use this small parts to cut this part from here. To do that, we'll just select this part, go to object path, and divide object below. That's a very important tool. In this way, we select this one, go to object path, divide object below. So here we have to cut it, we have divided from here, so just ungroup it and delete the part which we don't need. Now we got almost all our parts. We got the circle, we got the piece of rectangle and of same thickness, but here you can see one more thing is there, the intersection part has been removed. That means the part which were intersecting has been removed, and Illustrator has a very special option here. You go to Pathfinder and you find it, there is a shape modes where you can combine, subtract, you can intersect, you can left the intersection part, or you can remove the intersection part, and this is the part which we need to extrude that part. So just select both the object and extrude it away. So here we go, we got the same object with a very special and procedural way. This is how you can make your logo. Hope you enjoy the tutorial. Thank you very much.